Okay. Oh, you're so gorgeous. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right.
What do you like the best about Wheaties?
Oh my gosh, I love breakfast cereal always, and Wheaties is substantive. That beautiful brown color and the crunchiness, no matter how much milk you put on it or how long you leave the milk, it's always substantive. You know how those wimpy cereals break down and they're no good after about 10 seconds? Wheaties stays with you, which I love.
Not only that, but many athletes, it doesn't matter what sport you are, from MMA to boxing or basketball, if someone has a bad day, you didn't have your... Why do they always say that? You didn't have your Wheaties?
About? That's right. You need your Wheaties. So, because it endures. Because it keeps you strong for a long time so you can last through the battle. That's why.
Brazil 2016.
Yes.
What's your prediction? What do you think? How do you think the USA will do this year?
We're going to crush. Serena and Venus are ready to crush in tennis. I think our track guys are ready to crush. Our women and our gymnastics team, we have some new chicks, some new cute little strong girls. They are ready to crush. I think it's going to be great and fun. So I'm hoping everybody stays nice and healthy, keep that nasty Zika thing away, and we should be fine in Rio.
When you participated, what's the toughest part of competing?
Oh, man. I think it's all about the mind. It's between the ears. What's going on between the ears? I know even now that I play tennis a lot, I'm a weekend warrior with a lot of tennis. And even if I can hit 10 aces on the court by myself, you gotta be able to hit that one at the important point, you know? And that's what separates the Queen Serena from everybody else.
Speaking of her, when I look at her, I look at Haley's comment. Once in 100 years an athlete like that comes along in any sport. She's a, Leila Ali said yesterday that's her favorite athlete.
Yes.
Everybody, she's doing history. I think fourth in history right now in most wins.
Tied for first.
Okay, tied for first.
Tied for first with Steffi Graf. And if she wins in the U.S. Open, she'll be the greatest of all time. The woman to have the greatest number of titles ever.
What makes her so special, besides the athletic ability?
Yeah, I'm telling you, it's that strength. It's that mental strength. And you can never count her out. If she's down a set, if she's playing horrible, if it's 0-5, everybody knows that she can come back, she can close, she can kill it, you know, at any moment and shut it down.
Everything you're saying, I agree with you, but why does the media sometimes give her a hard time or they portray her in a different light? Why is that?
You know what? There's so many stereotypes, not only around female athletes, but also around African Americans. And I think that our perception of femininity is too narrow, because I think it's very feminine to be strong and to look strong. All of our mothers had to be strong to bring us into the earth. You know, it takes a lot of strength just to participate in childbirth. And so it's really a sick and ridiculous myth that women should be wimpy and should be weak. And so when we see a woman like her, who is so exceptionally strong, not only mentally but physically, it surprises us and it takes us away from those stereotypes. It defeats all those stereotypes, and some people just can't handle it. But it doesn't matter, because she's here to stay. She is the queen, and hopefully she'll make it easier for the next female athletes.
Tell all the fans where to follow you on Twitter and Instagram if they're watching.
I'm at The Real Jeryl on Twitter and Instagram.
All right, there you have it. Stay tuned. Okay. ESNEWSReporting.com. I'm Melissa Quack reporting. So there you have it, another great video for ESNEWS. For ESNEWSReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekpak reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter at Sekpak, and you can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Sekpak.